and welcome to my channel Daily Jano. So today, what do you think? What we're going to learn? So I am very glad to tell you that we will learn about what river carries when they flow through the Himalayas, and what is tributaries and what is a basin. Okay, so let's start it. So first, I told you we will know what the rivers carry from the Himalayas, right? So what river carries when they flow through Himalayas? This is a question. So they carry broken pieces of rocks, sand and silt. So you will have a question that how they carry. Do they have a purse, bag or sack? No. How can river carry them? Because they don't have any hand or anything else. So I will tell you how. Now, one thing we have to keep in our mind when we are knowing about this, because they don't have any bag, sack like object. So we all had taken a ride of slides. This is a type of slopey thing. It is a type of slopey thing from which it is a stair. We climb up and go down at a speed, right? We go down at a speed because it's slopey. So it is slopey, we go down at a speed. But when we go down, we stop, right? We don't go down in a speed. We don't go in a speed because we had landed to a flat land. That is why our speed is now gone, right? Our speed is now gone. So as the same, we all know mountains are slopey, right? They are slopey. They are conical shape. Let's take a mountain, Mount Everest, right? You can see this conical in shape. Yeah, conical, like a cone. Yeah, ice cream cone. If we can put the ice cream cone in upside down ways, you can see it is like, mountains are like that, but a little bit rocky. Not smooth as the ice cream cone is, but rocky. That is, so this rocky are the mountains, but they are still slopey. They are rocky. They are not smooth, but they are rocky. But still, they are slopey. So the rivers that originate there or flow through the Himalayas are going down from the mountains in a great speed, in a very high, great speed, right? So there's some small pieces of rock, sand and silt are present there in the rocky slopes. So the rivers that go there down from the mountain slope carry these things with a great high speed, and not with a sack, not with a bag, or not with anything else, like a lot in pouches, bags, suitcases, but yes, with a great speed, right? With a great speed. So this speed remains as same as all time? No. Yes, we don't have everywhere mountains in India. No, somewhere we have plains, plateaus, deserts, mountains, seas, islands, right? But we don't have mountains everywhere. So when it's slopey, I told you the example, when we go down from a slide, we go in a great speed, but we go down, no speed is present there, right? no speed. But we just stop there. No speed is present, but we just stop there. So when we stop there, but the rivers not stop. They go with the speed from the mountains, but plain. Plain is a flat and level land is called plain. So in plains, the speed of the river gets reduces. It decreases. Not increases, but decreases. The speed decreases in plains, but not stops. It does not stops, but decreases in plains. So when it is decreases, the broken pieces of rocks, sand and silt is deposited in the sides of the river in the plains. It is called alluvium. It is called alluvium. So it is very fertile. Fertile means capable for growing crops. Right? Capable for growing crops. So it is very fertile. This alluvium, the fine silt, broken pieces of rock, sand is very fertile. When it is deposited, alluvium deposited in the sides, it is very fertile there. The land is very fertile and very good for growing crops. But not all your sand, silt, broken pieces of rock is deposited. Half of them are deposited and half of them are still present in the river. So, half of them are still present in the river. For now, goodbye.